Around the world, animal shows are one of the zoo's biggest attractions. Every year, thousands of people flock to top zoos to see cute animals perform tricks. Tricks that have them reeling in laughter and astonishment. But not everyone is amused. A quick interview with the people on the street drew mixed reactions.
I feel pretty bad when I see animal shows, honestly.
It's not very ethical because they are forcing animals to act in a way that they don't reach to do it. Because you have to like use food to tempt them to do something.
Let's say like animal shows in the zoos, I don't see what's wrong with that. I mean, it's a form of entertainment, but at the same time, by having such entertainment, you're making people more interested in animals.
If you start dressing them up, putting makeup, that's pretty bad, right?
In Singapore, the Singapore Zoo has three animal shows involving animals such as orangutans, elephants, and jackass penguins. The zoo says that the animal shows provide edutainment, that is, the animals educate the viewers while entertaining them. But while the Singapore Zoo sees it that way, not all animal activists agree. The World Association for Zoos and Aquariums, or WASA, which is a nature conservation body, has guidelines that state that wild animals can be involved in shows only if they are displaying their natural behavior and if the show has a strong conservation message. Animal activists Razor TV spoke to cautioned against making animals perform circus tricks or using animals for entertainment. They say it demeans the animal and is a form of cruelty.
Again, if you look at a lot of the shows, they still focus on a lot of circus-style behaviors. So the birds riding bicycles, orangutan performing boxing shows, even elephant shows, some of them are still focusing on circus-style tricks. And the key here is also not just about the welfare of the animals, but again what the take-home message is for the younger audience. If you go and see a show where the animals are just performing circus tricks, the only thing you get out of it is that these animals are here for us to entertain us and we can make them do whatever we want. And it just reinforces the message that man is above nature rather than we're a part of nature.
Seeing them being kept in a structure like a swimming pool and doing tricks or having photographs taken, I'm sure that the animals are not happy. I think it's all about conditioning. And I think it is cruel to keep animals in captivity for the purpose of entertainment. The conservation message, it gets lost in the process because the public are so amused, and they think, oh, how did he do that, you know, that trick, and oh, isn't that great? And I think very often it doesn't go beyond that.
Lewis, who heads the Animal Concerns Research and Education Society, has travelled to more than 100 zoos in the last 10 years.
I'll give you an example of Monkey Maya in Australia in Perth, where the dolphins come every day to the shore so that they interact with people, and it's their choice. If they're not happy that day, they don't come. If they come near and they don't like the person, they swim away. But in a zoo situation, they must be given this choice as well. If you're forcing the animals to always be in contact with humans, then obviously there is welfare concerns.
When Razor TV asked the Singapore Zoo, it said that it does not make the animals practice circus-style tricks. Instead, the zoo is committed to animal conservation and offers a safe habitat for animals to live and breathe. But are zoos really the best place to keep wild animals for conservation? We asked the experts in the next clip.